Hello, Vital Sign. Today we're going to talk about Faa di Bruno's formula and how to find higher order derivatives using the formula. Faa di Bruno's formula is used to generalize the chain rule for higher order derivatives. Let's take a look at a motivating example first. So, say we want to find the first derivative of a function h of x, which we define to be f of x composed with g of x. How would we do this? We could apply the chain rule and find its first derivative. But I'd like to rewrite this in a way that'll help us later in the video. Let's make those prime marks into numbers denoting the order of the derivatives of f and g. For example, the second derivative of f of x would be f2 of x, the third derivative would be f3 of x, and so on. For the purposes of this video, we could call those little numbers near f derivative exponents. But keep in mind that they are not ordinary exponents denoting repeated multiplication. Instead, they're denoting repeated differentiation. Now back to finding nth derivatives. It would be very tedious if we had to find the fifth or the sixth derivative of a function composition like f of g of x. We would have to apply the product and chain rules over and over again. Thankfully, there's an easier way to do it. Faa di Bruno's formula. Faa di Bruno's formula states that when you have a function composition f of g of x, the nth derivative is given by the following expression. Let's go over what each part of this expression means. This expression is saying that the nth derivative of the function composition f of g of x is equal to this sum here. One thing I want to point out is that the exponents directly next to the functions f and g are derivative exponents, denoting the order of the derivative of the functions f and g, while the exponents outside of the parentheses are actual exponents denoting repeated multiplication. Also, this sum is not like your typical sum that you see in calculus, where you have an index I that ranges between two integers. Instead, in Faa di Bruno's formula, we're summing over all sequences of numbers, m1 through mn, that meet a given condition. What does this mean? Think back to the sums we're used to seeing. If we have a sum that looks like this, where our index ranges from 1 to 5, it means to consider the set of integers from 1 to 5, plug each one into the summation expression, and add up the results to get our final answer. In the Faa di Bruno formula sum, however, instead of plugging in a single number from a set of numbers, like how we plugged in 1 through 5 from the set 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 into the expression 2i, we are plugging in sequences of numbers m1 through mn from a set containing some number k of different sequences of numbers m1 through mn that satisfy the following condition. Again, instead of letting our index travel from a set of integers as we sum, say from 1 to 5, our index travels a set of sequences of numbers. So we will plug in entire sequences of numbers, m1 through mn, into our expression for Faa di Bruno's formula and add up the results from those sequences to get our final answer. So what does the condition highlighted in yellow mean? To show you what this condition means, let's say n equals 3. Since n equals 3, each sequence will range from m1 to m3. And they'll have to satisfy the condition that m1 times 1 plus m2 times 2 plus m3 times 3 equals 3. Our job now is to find all possible sequences of positive integers m1, m2, m3 that satisfy this condition. One possible sequence of m1, m2, m3 that would satisfy the condition would be m1 equals 1, m2 equals 1, and m3 equals 0. Why does this sequence satisfy the condition? Because 1 times 1 plus 1 times 2 plus 0 times 3 equals 1 plus 2, which equals 3. You can see how this matches up to the condition below. Another sequence of m's that satisfy the condition when n equals 3 would be m1 equals 0, m2 equals 0, and m3 equals 1. You can see how this sequence satisfies the condition below. And the last sequence of m's that satisfies the condition when n equals 3 is m1 equals 3, m2 equals 0, and m3 equals 0. This corresponds to 1 plus 1 plus 1, which equals 3. This may seem a little complicated, but all we're really doing is listing the different ways of writing n as a sum of positive integers less than or equal to itself. In this case, 3 can be written as 3, 1 plus 2, or 1 plus 1 plus 1. These are known as integer partitions, as we are splitting the integer into parts that can be summed to that integer. Now, for each of these partitions, m1 is the number of times 1 appears in the partition. M2 tells us how many times 2 appears in the partition. And M3 tells us how many times 3 appears in the partition. Each integer partition of 3 maps to a unique sequence of integers M1 through M3 that describes the occurrences of the integers 1 through 3 in that partition. So generally, when we sum over all k unique sequences of numbers, m1 through mn, that satisfy the constraint in Faa di Bruno's formula, we are in a sense summing over all unique integer partitions of n. So to recap, the first thing to do when you're working with Faa di Bruno's formula to find an nth derivative is to list out the integer partitions of n and then map each one to its sequence of numbers m1 through mn that uniquely describes it, creating a set of sequences of numbers, m1 through mn. Then the next thing to do is plug in the numbers m1 through mn of each sequence into the formula, and finally sum the results for each sequence to find the nth derivative. Now there's still a few more things to cover in this formula. You might be wondering what this means. This is the product symbol, the multiplicative equivalent of the summation symbol or sigma. So it's asking us to multiply this term here as our index j ranges from 1 to n. Finally, it's time to put this formula to work. Let's use it to find the fifth derivative of f of g of x. First, what are the integer partitions of 5? Feel free to pause the video and find them yourself. Here they are. What sequences of m1 through mn can we find through these integer partitions? Again, feel free to pause and work it out yourself. Here are our sequences of numbers m1 through mn, corresponding to each integer partition. So now that we have our sequences, let's work through each sequence and substitute the numbers m1 through mn in each sequence into Faa di Bruno's formula, remembering that n equals 5 as we're finding a fifth derivative. Here's the first summand, using the sequence m1 equals 5, m2 equals 0, m3 equals 0, m4 equals 0, and m5 equals 0. That's our first summand. Here's the second summand, corresponding to the sequence m1 equals 3, m2 equals 1, and m3 through m5 equal to 0. That's our second summand. Here's our third summand. Now let's go on to the fourth summand. That's our fourth term in the sum. Three more to go. Here's the fifth summand. Two more to go now. Here's our sixth summand. And now for our final summand. using this seventh sequence of M1 through M5. That's our last term in the sum. Now, adding them all up, we get this. That's the answer. That's the fifth derivative of f of g of x. Now, this was still a lot of work, but the nice thing about Faa di Bruno's formula is that it gives us a straightforward, systematic way of finding higher derivatives, instead of having to apply the product and chain rules many times. So again, to find the nth derivative of f of g of x, find the integer partitions of n, map them to their sequences of numbers m1 through mn, and sum over each sequence of m1 through mn, remembering that the exponents next to the functions are derivative exponents, and the exponents outside the parentheses are true exponents. The purpose of this video was to show you how to use Faa di Bruno's formula. In my next video, I'll explain why repeated differentiation is so related to integer partitions. And in another video, I will explain why this big fraction below counts the ways of partitioning a set a specific way. So if you want to dig a little deeper into the whys behind this formula, stay tuned for my next two videos. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, like, share, and comment. Have a great day.